Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Graffiti Smash on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Graffiti Smash and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Graffiti Smash. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, the first thing to do is to open our main internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to this URL I'm highlighting in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type this URL, because I added a link in the description of this video and the first main comment. We landed at this point on our own website of Usitility, exactly where we find here a meticulous demonstration on the way to obtain Graffiti Smash on computer. We scroll lower a tad and click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we get to the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will load to enjoy the game Graffiti Smash on the PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of advantages of preferring using the emulator. Now we are on the way to start downloading the Graffiti Smash by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on the button. And the download step takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the device. We said yes. I minimize the web browser to start to see the installer significantly better. The installer is very simple to use. It is made up of two choices, install and setup path. I will make it clear what setup path genuinely does. We purely click it. And we realize that we display here the path where the emulator is going to be set up. If we are planning to change for better this folder we have to click on this Browse option, and we pick another folder and install the emulator specifically where we like. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. I simply click on Back. And I just click on Install. Now, there it is. The install commences and it will move forward in the download of all these MB that happens to be presented on that computer screen. When you save it on your hard disk, it is likely to be more or less MB. The data transfer rate might go faster or at a lower speed, subject to your web access and according to the performance of the emulator web servers. Now they are running incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has actually been started automatically. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right and once it has reached the ending, the emulator can be launched for the very first time. In fact, the emulator has been started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue, as now you can see, it created two software icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon will be one we are concerned with. Whenever we desire to start Graffiti Smash on our laptop or computer, we twice click this software icon and consequently launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's conduct the next phase, which is a requirement, and this is to visit the Google Play Store. And we'll just click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is presented. In this case we have to sign in. Now once we're here, we are required to execute this next phase that is definitely compulsory. Therefore we mouse click on Sign In. Now it announces Checking Info. It might sometimes get blocked in Checking Info, that's why it fails to continue. If so, you may attempt to log in after a couple of hours it's going to most probably be sorted out. Now we can type our email and password. The email address really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its related password. For instance, you can utilize the same email address you're using right now in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to insert my info and I'll come back immediately after I have completed it. That's it, info typed. Here is Google welcoming us and providing us their tools. We must consent to all of them simply by clicking I agree. Next, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can let it selected and this will generate a backup of the files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can utilize that feature if you wish. We click Accept. Google Play is started without need to open it manually and automatically. To set up the application, we would need to get to the emulator desktop for Android by left-clicking that app icon marked green-colored. Now that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator, we observe that we find there the install app game option. We mouse-click on that button. Here we come with the Android game. So let's press now on the install choice that I'm just showing now in green. And it will launch the software setup. At this moment it should install the Android game, it normally takes a little while or it could also be very fast. This all is subject to on our internet access. This has actually finished setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking the following button that I'm emphasizing in green, if you want to use Graffiti Smash for the very first time. We are presently on the emulator desktop, and we're about to just click the fresh Graffiti Smash software icon which has been generated. The game app is started for the first time. Currently there we end up with it, I am able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will talk about the sound level of the emulator. It's right here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of this emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we can switch on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is simply the very first one, we click on this particular app icon which I am basically showing in green. And the display screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. If we choose to launch the game in full screen, we select that software icon. And we might without a doubt be enjoying the video game in 100% screen function. To stop the complete screen setting, push the F11 key. And we'd just be in regular display screen setting. Now I am on the way to clarify you the keyboard mapping that is certainly surprisingly cool. That means we may be ready to use the video game far more easily. The first task is to click this keyboard icon. It's now time to complete the necessary adjustments. I'll go ahead and let the normal settings, however if you prefer to improve it, you can easily do so without any problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our own language. From time to time it happens that your emulator is presented in the erroneous language, for instance, in Chinese language. And to set it up in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. And right here throughout other configurations, we just click that language drop down. We will determine the language we wish, Spanish, Japanese, and so forth. Once the language is selected, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, as well as the video game, the next time we start it, will also be in the preferred language. Now, you can find another point that we must take into account, and this is that we will get an email reporting that a brand new machine has been connected with our Google account. It will certainly check with us if we are the individuals who have associated with that device. Indeed, we ought not get worried, since the emulator is behaving like an Android electronic device. And to determine which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we return right here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. And we browse here to the model selection. And here we notice that the emulator is simulating a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for my tutorial. I believe you appreciated it, especially that everyone thought it was handy. In that case, bring it a good like, subscribe, and if you have feedback, requests or suggestions, leave them in the comment field down below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every now and then, you have it down below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click any of the videos which are usually showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming video tutorials. Bye.